today we are looking at the current found set portal, or the master detail, if you will, that FileMaker has introduced. It's pretty cool. It allows you to do some pretty neat stuff. Namely, you no longer have to go through the list view and keep bumping back and forth, or even just tabbing through here without really knowing, you know, what you're looking for or who's there. You can just do that right here off to the side, and you can see bits of information that might be useful to the user to differentiate one thing from another. And you can just click on it, and it'll bring their information up. Really cool, really powerful. It just tabs straight through whichever records you want. A neat aspect of this, too, since it's looking at just your current found set, neat application with finds. It'll actually keep track of what finds you're making. You can see that this is going to start appearing off to the left. So if you have issues keeping track or a long find request, you can keep track of what's going on right here because it's going to act just like any other find list, any other found set, and you can see it's going to reflect then your new found set once you've made that find. So now you've got a more limited list, and it'll allow you to do that. So the master detail here, super powerful, makes it a lot easier instead of having to flip through those lists to just maintain your screen and just flip through here. So now that we've kind of looked at what that's all about, what we're going to do is go into layout mode, and I will show you on this layout how to actually create a master detail portal. Very simple. We're going to go into layout mode. It's just your good old-fashioned portal tool up top here, and we'll lay that out, make it nice and pretty. And what we're going to do is basically just select, instead of selecting one of the related tables, we're going to select the table we're actually on currently. And when you do that, FileMaker is going to remove your ability to sort the records, filter the records, et cetera, because you have to remember you're on the current found set, so we can't alter that found set from this portal. You have to do it like you would any other found set normally. But it does allow you to do some stuff like alternate row state and active row state like any other portal. So we're going to hop in here, and we're just going to select name. That's probably the most useful for now. And add that in there, and that's it. We now have our found set portal. You might want to do a couple things like make sure that you can't edit this information or edit how this shows up so that it doesn't look like you can edit that information, but at the end of the day, that's really all we're looking for. It's going to work just fine, just like that.